Hey everyone, I hope you're doing amazingly well today. And today I have some big news for you over here. With everything that's been going on in the US, and I'm sure that you already know that there are riots and protests going on in the US, you know, especially what happened yesterday in the Capitol, it's genuinely depressing what's going on. And it kind of gives the world a whole new image of the US. That's something that they should definitely try to avoid, you know, given that their reputation is definitely something that will go on for ages, right? And President Trump is in huge part, I think, involved in whatever's going on. Well, you know, with all the suspensions on the Twitter and Facebook and everything else that's going on, this new rule has also come out quite recently. This was yesterday itself, that the H-1B selections are now going to be based upon the salary levels. Remember that we talked about this before in a previous video where I explained the salary levels and, you know, how they're going to be distributed, how based on each and every occupation, the salaries are going to be divided into, basically the people are going to be divided into four categories, you know, level 1, 2, 3, 4, based on your salary. Level 4 being the people with the highest salaries, level 1 being the people with the lowest salaries, okay? So, again, this is important, guys. So, that's the context that you needed to understand this video. And, you know what, that rule was, you know, still not on pen and paper, but now it's going to come into effect in 60 days, okay? So, still, is it going to come into effect in reality? Let's find out, okay? So, with just a few days left for Biden administration to take charge, the annual H-1B cap lottery process has been replaced with a salary-based selection process. The proposal was issued by the President Trump administration a few days before the US elections and public comments were invited. Now, this final rule has been published and will come into effect in 60 days. However, and this is the important part, guys, it can be rescinded by the new administration. If the Biden administration does not want this rule to stay, it can definitely go away. Okay, so now we already know that, you know, Trump's moving out of the office, and at the same time, Biden's going to be coming into power. He has the power to change this. He still can, and he still might. But at the same time, you know, a lot of immigration consultants, a lot of people working in the immigration industry are in general against this rule. They're saying that it will not stand in the court of law. Let me actually read further to you guys. According to the new rule, the H-1B visas would be allocated according to the wage levels. Now, you all already know that every single year, 85,000 visas are given out, you know, combined, given that you have advanced degree or not, regardless of that, 85,000, that's the cap. And now, Up till now, at least, the people were selected on a random basis. There's a lottery, and based on that lottery, some random people would get the visas, okay? That's what Trump is trying to finish off. He wants that, you know, only the people with the highest salaries can stick around. So, of course, you know, the employers have to pay you more, that's for sure. You know, if they want you in the company, they have to pay you more. And secondly, if, you know, you're not above that level 3 or level 4, then it's going to be very, very hard for you to actually gain an H-1B permit, okay? So let me actually walk you through what people think about this, okay? Again, you know, like I pointed out in the previous video also, level 4 and level 3, level 4 will get it, level 3, it's, you know, going to be a little bit still congested, but level 1 and 2, these are the people who are going to be impacted the most. If your salaries are amongst the lowest or, you know, in the lower average range of the salaries for your profession, you may not be able to secure an H-1B. And that's what's going on, all right? So a lot of people have basically talked about, you know, over here we can see Rajiv S. Khanna, managing attorney of immigration.com. He says that the policy shift will almost certainly be found to be untenable by the courts. Basically, it cannot be defended in the courts. That's what he's trying to say. You know, apart from that, Charles Cuck over here, the managing partner of Cuck Baxter Immigration LLC, also says that, you know, the new H-1B lottery system regulation was just published. It is now a lottery illegally based upon the salary. Litigation will shortly be filed to enjoin this nonsense. The rule of law continues to not matter Trump and his nativist minions. So you can see that most people who are working in this industry, who have been working in this industry, and they know how things work for the last few years, you know, and it's not just a few years, actually, it's been all the time in the world ever since the program was implemented. That's more fair in general. And, you know, this essentially will, of course, you know, not only sideline the Trump's objective, that is, you know, that immigrants should not be able to take American jobs, of course. But at the same time, when there's more jobs than there are people to fill it, you know, Native Americans to fill it, they should be letting the whole current scheme, I think, be in action. I think there's really nothing wrong with it, and it gives a fair chance to everyone. Yes, you know, some people might be all in for this one as well, but I think that, you know, given that employers will have to raise salaries just to keep the employees, it can have a potentially negative impact. So it's probably for the best if this thing gets squashed in the courts. And, you know, I'll be giving you more updates coming soon on this video, on this channel itself. You know, if you haven't subscribed to the channel as of yet, I would advise you to subscribe to it so that, you know, whenever the next update comes out, I'll be the first person to tell you. I promise you that. All right. Thank you so much for watching this video, guys. If you like the effort that I'm putting in, give me a thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next one. Thank you so much. Goodbye. Take care.